Hi, how are you? Good. Thank you for coming in today. What I'm going to be looking at today is your skin type. So I'm going to be getting very close and having a very thorough inspection of your skin, which should tell me whether you have oily or dry skin. And I'm also going to be able to tell you what your skin undertone is. And that will be able to give you an indication of what types of colours will work well with your skin, what colours in terms of makeup or hair dye or clothes. And it's a really useful piece of information that you can take away. So, first of all, I'm going to start with the skin type test. And I'm going to first clean your face and then I'm going to begin an examination, okay? And then I'll move on to looking at your undertones, okay? So I'm just going to clean my hands first with some antibacterial hand gel. Just taking a cotton pad and I'm just going to spray it with some antiseptic spray. And I'm just going to use this to clean your face. So it's really important that I clean your face of any dirt. Otherwise, I can have a false result. And will allow me to really see skin. If you could close your eyes. I hope you don't mind. I'm going to come quite close. Is that okay? Now we tend to have different skin types across the face. So you'll have slightly different skin type on your nose than you will on your forehead and cheeks and chin. So I'm just going to be pinching different areas. To see which bits are dry, which bits are oily, and whether there might be a combination skin type. So just looking at your T-zone, which is this part of the face, okay? So it's looking slightly more oily on this part of the face. I'm just going to have a look around the nose. Yeah, this is quite oily here as well. Cheeks. Okay, it's not as oily. In fact, it looks like there are some dry areas. Around the eyebrows, and across the cheeks. I'm just gonna press different areas. I'm just going to pinch, it won't hurt. is looking like you've got very oily skin just up on your nose and above your eyebrows, and then on the tip of your nose and on your cheeks. It's looking a lot drier. So I would say you've got combination skin. would say that's around the hairline. Around the jaw. So I would say that your T-zone was quite severely dry. Okay. I would say is to be applied daily. You can buy this from us if you want. Actually, I might see if we've got some free that you can take away with you. It's not really fair to charge you. Is your skin undertones, okay? I'm just going to clean my hands again with the antibacterial hand gel. Just already had a good look at your skin. And I'm not just going to look at the face now, okay? I'm going to look at the rest of your body. And I'm going to be telling you what your skin undertones are. So first, I'm going to work out whether you have a warm or a cool undertone. Okay, so if you could just pass me your wrist, okay? So, I'm just looking at the veins on your wrist. So, if you look, now it would be harder to see if you have a darker skin tone, but there are other ways of checking. So, I'm going to have a look first at your wrist. So, we've got slightly greenish veins, and some purple, and slight blue as well, but mainly green. I'm going to look at the other side now. So we've got, again, mainly green. And some purple and a little bit of blue, but it's mainly green, okay? And now I'm just gonna look at your face again, okay? And if you could just lift your head up, I'm gonna look at the color of your neck. Is whether you have yellow or pink undertones. Now, regardless of the colour of your skin, whether you're darker skin toned or whether you have a paler skin tone, you will either have yellow or pink undertones. Okay. So looking at your wrists and looking at your neck, it does look like you have a warmer skin tone, because your skin tone is slightly yellow, ever so slightly yellow. And although there are parts of your face with slightly pink skin tone, skin undertones, overall I would say you have a yellow skin undertone. So what we can do is we now split the undertone, whether it's yellow or pink, into four types. So we have spring, summer, winter, and autumn. So it's spring and autumn, which are the warmer undertones. Now looking at your eye colour, I can see that, yep, you have some golden tones in your iris. Very, very beautiful. If you ever get a chance, please do look at your iris in the mirror. A lot of people's irises resemble flowers. I know that mine are green, and I have some yellow in my iris. My mum's eyes are actually more yellow than they are green. So, yes, I can see very golden iris. And then your hair. So I'm looking at the undertone. Does look like, again, you've got some golden tones in your hair. Okay. spring or autumn, and you're probably more towards the autumn, okay? So I would encourage you to look at very warm yellow based colours, and you can tell this by putting certain colours up against your skin, and if a certain colour makes you glow, then you know that it's going to be right for you. But if you put a colour up against you and it kind of washes you out slightly, then I would say it's probably a cool colour and wouldn't go with your skin tone. And then in terms of hair dye as well, I would obviously encourage you to have your natural hair colour. I know that I actually have blonde hair that's been dyed, and my natural hair colour is slightly darker and more warm than this. Eventually I'd like to grow it out and have my natural hair, and I would say the same for you. Okay, I'm just going to make some notes of what I've seen so far. So your eyes are very golden, and the same for your hair as well, it's golden. Skin is, although there are areas where it's pink undertones, overall I would say it was yellow. Your eyebrows are same colour as your natural hair, and they're always going to be darker, so eyebrows are a good indication as well. And I would say that wearing warmer colours will give you a glow, make you look brighter. If you had cooler skin toned, then I would say colours that have a very cool undertone, so very light blues, some yellows, we've got greens as well, but all that have slightly more bluish tones to them. Mm-hmm. So we said that you were slightly more autumn. So the other thing I wanted to check was your skin condition in terms of sun damage. Now, because you have a warmer skin tone, you tan a lot easier, but that means you're more likely to have skin damage, whereas someone that has very cool undertones who would burn very easily, they're more likely to wear sun cream and therefore have less sun damage, although their skin would burn more easily. I would say you have to wear sun cream all the time. Don't take any risks, because you might look good now, but when you are older, you will regret not wearing sun cream. Okay, and I would say that SPF 30 is as good as SPF 50. There is not a lot of difference, and you must consult your doctor before buying any sun cream, and you know, you'll want to ask them what the best one is. But personally, I get SPF 50 because I don't want to take any risks. But you need to